Recently, we have received lots of emails from moms-to-be who wanted to know, how can I make sure that my baby grows in my womb as expected? The answer is, it's not always possible to make sure of that, but there are certainly things that you can do to support your baby's growth.
Yes. So in this video, we are first going to discuss why there is not necessarily a problem when your fetus is small. And then we're going to share with you the 7 things that you can try to support your baby's growth.
This is Nathalie, a pregnancy and birth consultant and TCM therapist.
And that's Mathias, a researcher and science geek. And on this channel, we help mummies and their babies naturally and science-based.
So how can you help your baby grow? When your doctor tells you that your fetus is small during a scan, then it does not automatically mean that there's a problem. During a checkup, your doctor estimates your baby's size and then compares that size to a standard chart. Mm-hmm. That chart tells them how your baby compares to thousands of other babies at that particular stage of a pregnancy. However, if you look at the school class, for instance, you're gonna see that not every child is equally tall, right? And so the challenge for your doctor is to determine whether your baby is just a small baby or whether there are underlying reasons that prevent your baby from fulfilling their growth potential, right?
Yes. So let's assume that your baby girl is in the 25th percentile, then this means that on average, out of 100 baby girls, your baby is smaller than 75 other girls and larger than 25 other girls. Mm-hmm. Does this mean that your baby is not growing as your baby should? No, not necessarily. Maybe your baby is just smaller. What does matter is consistent growth.
Yeah.
And so the question is, during the next scan, does your baby remain in the same percentile or even above, or is she now suddenly in a lower percentile? When the latter is the case, then it could mean that there are reasons that prevent your baby from fulfilling their growth potential.
Yes. Now, on the one hand, there can be medical reasons why your baby is not growing as expected, which may not be easy to control. For example, if you suffer from a chronic disease or if your placenta is not working as it should, then it is just very difficult for yourself to do anything about that. All you can do really in such cases is try to stabilize the problem together with your doctor so that at least it does not get worse. On the other hand, scientists have found that there can also be reasons which are related to lifestyle, which could either cause a fetus to be small, given their age, or have a low birth weight. Mm-hmm. These are things that normally are under your control, and so by taking care of them, you might be able to at least reduce the risk that your baby does not grow as expected. Mm-hmm. So let's have a look at them.
Sometimes women tell us that they are doing like 200 squats per day in order to prepare for labor.
Yeah.
And while we absolutely admire such high levels of motivation, there are some scientific studies that show that such high volumes of exercising may not be the best thing to do.
Yeah.
Not in general, but at least during the third trimester of a pregnancy.
Yes. To be totally honest with you, this is an ongoing controversy among scientists, but there is some evidence that high volumes of exercising in late pregnancy could reduce fetal placental growth, which means growth that is related to both the placenta and the baby. On top of that, some scientists have found that exercising in a high volume during late pregnancy may slightly increase the length of a pregnancy by about 1.5 days on average. So in brief, exercising while you're pregnant in general is great, right? Because it can benefit the baby and the mother in many ways.
Right.
However, many scientists recommend keeping the volume of exercising at a healthy level during the third trimester in order to minimize the impact that high volume exercising could have on the baby's growth.
Right. Keep in mind that the question what a healthy level is for you really depends on many factors, like your age, your pre-pregnancy body mass index, if you're used to exercising, etc. But in general, high volume exercise means doing excessive training, including lots of repetitions, or training including heavy weights or high frequency training, etc.
Yeah.
But if you have any doubts, please discuss with your provider what an appropriate volume of exercise is in your particular case. In Interestingly, a study from China involving more than 10,000 women found that women who took afternoon naps of between 1 and 1.5 hours were 29% less likely to have a baby with low birth weight compared to women who did not nap during the day. On top of that, they also found that the frequency of the nap seems to play a role.
Mm-hmm.
Women who napped on 5 to 7 days per week were 22% less likely to have a baby with low birth weight.
Keep in mind though that this study was not a control experiment, right? So we cannot really say that there is definite proof that afternoon napping really prevents a low birth weight. Mm-hmm. However, as the scientists point out, the findings of their study do suggest that a 1 to 1.5 hours afternoon nap 5 to 7 days per week might help at least reduce the risk of a low birth weight. If you're not yet pregnant, then it could pay off to work on your pre-pregnancy body mass index.
Right.
There are many scientific studies which have shown that underweight women are at a higher risk of having a baby with a low birth weight, mm-hmm. as well as a small for gestational age baby, which means that baby's growth is not as we would expect it to be at a specific point in time during a pregnancy.
Right.
So if you're underweight and consider getting pregnant, you might want to try to increase your weight first. As important as your pre-pregnancy weight is an adequate caloric intake during your pregnancy. There is strong scientific evidence that if a pregnant woman is not gaining enough weight during her pregnancy, then your baby is at a higher risk of being small for gestational age, as well as having a low birth weight. Conversely, if a pregnant woman is excessively gaining weight during her pregnancy, her baby is more likely to be large for gestational age, and there is a higher risk of an increased birth weight.
Mm-hmm.
Neither of that is optimal because it can have long-term effects on the baby's health.
Yes. So if you want to make sure that your baby grows and gains weight normally, then one way how you can support that process is by making sure that your weight gain is within a certain range.
Mm-hmm.
To help you understand how much weight gain is appropriate for you, we have posted a table in the description below this video. That table shows you the weight gain guidelines that the Institute of Medicine has published in 2009, based on the recommendations by the World Health Organization.
Yes. On top of that, we also talk about the optimal caloric intake during a pregnancy in one of our other videos, which you can find in the description below this video. That said, the American College of Obstetricians and Gynecologists says that ideally your provider determines your body mass index at the beginning of your pregnancy, mm-hmm. so that they can tell you what an appropriate weight gain looks like in your case.
When you take care of an adequate caloric intake, it is also important to look at where those calories are coming from.
Yeah.
Of course, burgers and fries and fizzy drinks can also provide your body with calories, but they mostly provide your body with macronutrients, particularly fat and sugar. However, in order for your baby to grow and gain weight properly, your baby also urgently requires micronutrients such as vitamins and minerals.
Yes, studies have shown that micronutrient deficiencies during pregnancy can have serious implications on the developing baby,
mm-hmm.
particularly on baby's growth and weight.
Right.
And so the first step of making sure that baby gets what they need is eating a variety of healthy foods, including vegetables, fruits, cereals, bread, grains, dairy products, fish, and meat or meat alternatives.
On top of that, it can also make sense to take supplements, particularly iron and folic acid.
Yeah.
In fact, we explain in detail what kind of nutrients a fetus needs in one of our other videos, which you can find in the description below this video. But in general, we recommend consulting with your provider first before you take any supplements.
When a woman is pregnant, her body changes the way how it regulates blood sugar.
Right.
As a result, pregnant women often develop low blood sugar levels.
Mm-hmm.
And according to scientific studies, newborns of women with low blood sugar levels often weigh significantly less than women with normal blood sugar levels.
Right. Now, it's very important to understand that there are circumstances under which it is very difficult, if not impossible, to avoid low blood sugar levels.
Yeah.
For example, diabetes can cause low blood sugar levels in women when they take medications. Another example is morning sickness, because frequent vomiting can make your blood sugar levels drop. But on the other hand, there are also lots of lifestyle-related aspects which can cause low blood sugar levels.
Yeah.
Examples are when you're not eating enough, or exercise more than usual, or drink alcohol.
Yes, that said, mild forms of low blood sugar levels are unlikely to do any harm to your baby, right? However, we just want to make you aware of the impact that low blood sugar levels can have on your baby. So if you have the feeling that low blood sugar levels are an ongoing problem, then we encourage you to talk with your doctor about it. It's important to understand that it's your blood which carries both oxygen and nutrients from your placenta to your baby.
Right. And so one way to increase the chances of your baby to grow within a normal range is to increase the blood flow to the baby and to make sure that nothing interferes with that blood flow.
Yeah.
And since the blood flow to your baby is linked to your own blood circulation, there are several things that could help you increase the blood flow to your baby. We explain these things in detail in one of our other videos.
Yes. By the way, there's one more thing which could prevent your fetus from growing as expected. And that's alcohol, drugs and smoking.
Right.
So it's always a good idea to stay away from these, right? And finally, please keep in mind that under normal circumstances, there is really no need to be worried about your baby's growth.
Yeah.
But if you are concerned about your baby's growth, then we encourage you to talk with your doctor about your concerns so that they can evaluate if there is indeed a problem, and if so, to determine what is the best way to deal with the situation given your particular pregnancy case.
Right. If you have found this video helpful, we would be super grateful if you could leave us a like or even a comment in the comment section below.
Yes, and if you want to see more videos about pregnancy and baby-related topics in the near future, subscribe to our channel and hit the bell.